you speak to your parents every day? Raise your hands. Okay, put them down. How about for more than 30 minutes a day? Okay, more than an hour? What about your grandparents? Do you speak to them every day? Okay, so about 4 months ago, over the winter holidays, I went to visit my grandparents, 12,000 kilometers away in Cuba. When I came back and shared with people that I'd spent the holiday with my grandparents, helping my grandma with work around the embassy, the look in their eyes was like, why did you spend 2 weeks helping your grandmother around the embassy when you could have been going out with your friends every day? Since most of them knew I had been to Cuba, they probably also wondered why I hadn't spent most of my time at the beach getting tanned, taking selfies. That's when it dawned on me that very few people would go to the ends of the world for their family. It got me thinking about all the different things that people had shared with me from all the countries that I'd lived in, how they rarely share private things with their parents, how they barely know their grandparents, let alone speak to them every day. It's actually very sad that teenagers, people my age, our age, isolate themselves from their family to a point where they don't even speak to each other on a daily basis. And if they do, they don't have quality time together. Unfortunately, more often than not, this is a common situation that people find themselves in. I feel like my classmates don't confide in their parents and would rather turn to anybody else but them to share their problems and look for a solution. I mean, I've seen the way in which they act. Parents are rarely mentioned, and when they are, it isn't usually with the greatest sense of pride. Very often, this lack of pride comes from the social stigma that it isn't cool to spend time with your parents. Your friends are all you need. This belief, along with the increased use of social media by teenagers across the globe, has led to the loss of the direct connection between parent and child. When someone suggests to a teenager that they should discuss something with their parents, very often their first reaction is like, what? No, please, never. They wouldn't understand. They don't get me. God forbid they find out. Interestingly enough, while I was doing the research for my talk, one of my teachers posed a question to the class. They asked, do you think parents are good teachers? There was a wide array of answers, but the one that struck me the most was that to them, friends were the best teachers they could ever have. One girl said, I'm not that close with my parents. I feel that since I spend most of my time with my friends, they learn the most from me and I learn the most from them. Okay, great. I'm sure everyone, I mean all of us, have a blast with our friends. But can you really take advice from someone your own age? Sure, your friend might have been through a similar situation, or you could have seen it on someone's Instagram feed, but how objective was their decision really? Wouldn't it be better to get advice from someone older? I know you think your parents are old, but it wasn't so long ago that they were experiencing the same things that you are now. Although listening to your friends might seem like the most appealing option, it might lead you to making the wrong decision. Some of my classmates during that discussion went on to say that their parents, as nice as some of them may seem, couldn't understand what life was like for them today because they didn't live during the same time that we do. They said that their friends, and for some, their older siblings, understand them better because they actually live in today's world. When I asked them what the huge difference was between when our parents were our age and right now, I got the answer I probably dreaded the most: social media. Most people my age have bought into this social mentality that social media is most often the fastest and easiest way of communication. And in some cases, that is true. But it definitely stops being the best way of communication when you see a bunch of 12-year-old kids who are supposedly friends texting each other. When A, it's a sunny day outside, the perfect time to take a walk around campus. And B, they're most literally sitting 10 centimeters away from each other, just like you guys are now. But they still prefer to use Facebook or Instagram to talk to each other rather than have a face-to-face conversation. These actions, along with the social construct that one can't live without their phone, has led to teenagers losing touch with the real world. Studies show that a teenager is actually more likely to spend their afternoon locked away in their room playing a video game or chatting with their friends than going out and playing with their sibling or simply watching TV with their family. According to data from February 2016 from the Office of Adolescent Health in the USA, an organization that is dedicated to improving the health and healthy development of adolescents, teens use social media and their phones daily, with 71% of them using more than one platform, the most popular ones being Facebook, Instagram, and Snapchat. Although the Office of Adolescent Health claims that this happens daily, I beg to differ. I'm pretty sure every average teenager checks their phone when it lights up with a new message, which is basically like every 3 seconds. Further research from the Pew Research Center, a fact tank that informs us about the trends, attitudes, and issues that shape the world, shows that older teenagers, aged 15 to 17, are more than 60% likely to make a friend online. The increased amount of friendships online that teenagers have leads them to become comfortable behind a screen, often hiding behind it, where they don't have to have face-to-face interaction. It's much easier to live as an ideal version of yourself online rather than having to constantly face criticism in person. I mean, if you could, wouldn't you make your life look like a party on wheels on your Instagram or Snapchat? One thing you should remember, though, is that the people who see you with your hair sticking up the wrong way or saliva drooling down your chin when you wake up, namely your parents, are the ones who know the real you. At the end of the day, you could spend all your time with your friends, but it's your parents who remember little details, like the name of your first stuffed animal, what your first birthday was like, or when you lost your first tooth. The fact that teenagers spend so much time online with their friends means that at a certain age, the time that they spend with their parents is significantly minimized, when in fact, they should be striving to spend more time with their parents. It has been statistically proven that spending time with your parents can have positive effects on your life. Based on research from the Population Reference Bureau, an organization that aims to inform people about the population, health, and the environment, but the more time that teenagers spend with their parents means that they will have fewer behavioral problems and less delinquent behavior overall, they will have less substance abuse and higher math test scores. So in reality, although children avoid their parents, especially teenagers, they should be aiming to spend more time with them. I know that there are many things that we would do to score better on our math tests, but that shouldn't be the primary reason why you spend time with your parents. But building a stronger relationship with your parents doesn't mean you have to spend all your time with them. I mean, after all, we are growing up, and if nothing else, as students, we have to be in school for at least 8 hours every day. However, you can start by doing something simple. Now let's have a quick discussion. Turn to the person next to you and brainstorm ideas of what you would like to do with your family. Teenagers, you can talk about things you would enjoy doing with your parents. And parents, you can talk about things you would like to do with your children to strengthen your relationship. Okay, although that seems like a very active and engaging discussion, we are a bit short on time, so let's keep going. What did you guys come up with? Anyone? A sentence?
For example, I would love to do some skiing with my father, as it is something that bonds us.
Peter?
Going to the cinema with my parents.
Sinaki?
Play checkers with my father or go.
Those are all really great ideas. So as you all mentioned, building a stronger relationship with your parents can start by doing the small things. For instance, make sure all of your phones are off and away during dinner. That way you can discuss how everyone's days went. You can even text them beforehand if you have to remind them. Another interesting thing to do might be having breakfast together. I know, trust me, not everyone is a morning person, but it might be fun. And as some of you mentioned, another great idea would be doing something with them over the weekend. It could be playing a sport or signing up for an art class. It's a win-win situation. You get to do something you love or learn something new, and at the same time spend time with your parents. I speak from personal experience when I say that by spending time with my parents, I have found in them two of the best friends that I could ever ask for. From them, I have learned how to stand my ground when I have to defend my opinion. I have learned how to empathize with others and console them when they feel sad. I have learned how to take care of myself and of other people around me so that when the time comes, I can build a life for myself. I wanted to end by sharing with you something that my parents said and always tell me. I know, it's a bit cheesy, but it reminds me that no matter what, I will never be alone. My parents have always told me, no matter what you do, no matter when you do it, no matter how bad it is, even if you kill a person, you come and tell us. No matter what you have done, we will be behind you 1,000%, and we're the only ones who ever will. Don't get me wrong, family and friends aren't enemies. They go hand in hand, you know, they complement each other. So next time you want to share something, go ahead, share it with your best friend. That's what they're there for, right? But consider sharing it with your parents as well. I mean, you'll get two opinions on it, and you might find two new best friends. Thank you.